So just imagine if you didn't have to do so many manual tasks when it came to key certificate / machine identities. We're so used to doing things on board, and I have to generate my keys and generate my CSRs, and then the time I have to wait on getting that stuff approved, and just, you know, but that's your norm, it's what you know, right? So just imagine if you had the ability to, all of those things, you don't have to do them anymore. They're just all automated for you. How often do you think about this? You're thinking about it once every 2 years. So the problem is that you have to remember, okay, I've got to Google on how do I generate that CSR, how do I generate the keys. All of those things are automated, so it just goes away. When we think about those objections, we think about some of the potential stumbling blocks that we have is looking at, you have to give away a little bit of credential to be able to automate this task. And so I don't necessarily want somebody mucking around into my entire F5. Well, you don't necessarily have to give an admin account. It can be just, we use the least privilege access. So instead of saying you have root control over this entire application or my devices, Venafi is just going to use the least amount of privileges we need to in order to do the task that we're assigned. Whether that's doing installation, if it's validation, checking to make sure things are installed correctly, we do least privilege account access. So oftentimes administrator will say, I'm not so sure that I really trust this automation completely. I kind of want to trust you, but I'm not quite so sure how this really works. So with Venafi, we have the ability to place the key and certificate into a directory, but then the human, the administrator, can take the last mile of actually installing it. Or in the case of Apache, we want to do the installation, but I don't want Venafi to restart my services. I want to restart the services. So the last mile of control still relies on you. You take full advantage of all the automation, but then you still have the ability to say, I don't want to restart this service. And so you know nothing bad can ever happen unless you've got control of that. So the outcomes typically are knowing that once you see the automation working, you know that it does work, and you know that it's safe, it's secure, it's not going to break things. It's the realization that I no longer have to worry about these things. The automation works, I'm very happy, I get my time back. The security team, when they ask you, where's that private key? Well, you didn't ever touch the private keys. All of those things are automated now. If audit teams start asking questions, no problem, we have all of those things covered. So we don't have to worry about the security aspects because we know that's handled, and the automation, so all of those manual tasks, they're completely gone, so you get back to doing things that are more important than just worrying about installing keys and certificates.